All is now set for All Progressive Congress governorship primary in Kogi State ahead of the governorship election slated for November 21st, 2015. 27 All Progressive Congress governorship aspirants have been screened ahead of primary slated for August 29 in Lokoja, Kogi State capital. Cross-section of the aspirants have been speaking on their programs of action. One of the aspirants, Femi Obadofin, said his administration will focus on the welfare drive of the people of Kogi State.
We have social problem, that is unemployment, and personality ends where hunger begins. If you don't address the issue of hunger, good qualitative food, welfare package for the society, you are just deceiving yourself. It has to be followed by development of the society itself, infrastructure. You have to open up the rural areas. You have to also renew the urban centers. Our urban centers were better during the colonial time, and it shouldn't be. Taps were running better. Electricity was more stable. This is an indictment to our generation. So to address this, I'm starting from Kogi State, that small enclave. I want to show a model of how society should be. That's why I'm contesting.
Haliru Shuhaibu said he will turn around the fortune of the state within the next 6 months if given the mandate.
We have over 27 mineral resources in Kogi State. But as we speak today, only two were tapped. 25 is still on tap. It's on tap because neither the leaders or the people that lead the state or manage the state are less focused, or rather, what we call limit of knowledge and information. As a businessman who has traveled far and wide, I have built a network of contacts. I have built serious investment contacts around the world. And this is my backbone. I can transform Kogi within 6 months.
On his part, Yakuin Habib promised to tackle the problem of unemployment in the state.
It is the state and our condition of Kogi State that has compelled me to come out to contest the leadership of that state. Today, if you see that we are in a sorry state, today, the state has become a place for armed robbery as well as kidnapping. People are no longer. The level of unemployment in Kogi State is alarming. For the last 10 years, just to say the least, we have not employed people in that state.
Speaking on the quest for the power shift to the minority area of the state, former governor of the state, Adu Abubakar, said the state at the moment requires service of a competent hand at the ends of affairs.
About 8 gentlemen, some professors, some doctors, some generals in the retired generals in the army and navy, they came to me on this call, say I should withdraw from the contest and promote somebody from the central and west to be the candidate of the party. And I said, this is a dissenting voice on the field. Majority of the people say I should contest and bring the state to the level I left it in 2003. And you are saying a different thing. However, I crave the indulgence that I am a protagonist of power shift.
Meanwhile, the national leadership of All Progressive Congress has said that it has no preferred candidate for the Kogi governorship election. The APC organizing secretary, Senator Osita Izunaso, explained that the party will create a level playing field for all the aspirants.
I remind all our aspirants that the battle is not for them, but the battle is outside. The battle is for us to wrestle power from our opponents. not for us to wrestle power from amongst ourselves. So whenever you are doing primaries, it is an in-house affair. It is not an external battle yet, because all of you who are aspiring are first of all bona fide members of the APC. And we don't have provision for two governorship candidates. We have provision for only one governorship candidate. So it is going to be from amongst you that that one person will emerge. But what are we expected to do as a party? We are expected to give you a level playing ground.
APC governorship primary for Kogi State have been slated for 29th of August, where the party flag bearer will emerge for the governorship race in the state. From Party Secretariat Abuja, Muyiwa Bamdele reporting.
Chairman of the Police Service Commission, Sir Mike Okwiru, has expressed happiness over the outcome of the investigation conducted by the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offences Commission, ICPC, that exonerated him of misappropriation of funds and embezzlement of the sum of 275 million naira, as alleged by one Mr. Aaron Kasi, a staff of the commission. While speaking to Ben Television in Abuja, Sir Mike Okwiru stated that though it was not a sweet experience for him and his loved ones, but he knew that the truth will always come out no matter how long.
I feel highly elated that I've been vindicated. This has given me tortuous almost 3 months since this saga started, which a device to blackmail me. I turned it down. This was a petition that I sold 275 billion for the state 350. Later 275, up again to 500 as published in some newspapers. Then ICPC was invited to come and clear this. But at a point, my BP went up. And my children were calling me every now and then, "Daddy, what is happening at what place? They come and confront us, your father stole money." I told them, "Hold on, the ICPC report to come out." Which was still taking long. We just had to say something. That was why now called a press conference, which turned the tide. People now had my own side of the story. And I ended by saying the ICPC was still investigating, so I didn't want to preempt the report of the ICPC. I'm happy that the report of the ICPC came out, and the chairman, in paragraph 3 of the report, said the investigation has not revealed any act of criminal infraction against the person of Sir Dr. Mike Bamokiro, the chairman of Police Service Commission, as all issues outlined above are administrative in nature and within the ambit of the career public servants' handlings. So that has really vindicated me.
On the need to recruit more personnel into the police force, the retired IGP said over 11,000 police officers have left the force for the past 4 years, either by retirement, dismissal, or death, emphasizing that the commission has made several requests to the federal government in this regard.
I came into the Police Service Commission in June 2013. By November, I wrote a memo to the government that we were investigating police activities in the election 2015, and that needed to recruit police officers to enable police perform their duties during the election. I recommended 1,000 from each state, 500 from Abuja, making the 6,500. By January, the commission was invited to the presidency to defend my memo. I defended that, and the government came up with the fact that there's no money. Reason be that, wait, we recruited 6,000 people. You have to train them. The police colleges were dilapidated. The police colleges needed to be renovated. The trainees need to be trained and fed and housed. Above all, you need to pay the salaries when they pass out. The government said there was no money. So that's how we stand up to now. Unfortunately, between that time and now, over 11,000 police officers have received the force, either by way of retirement, death, dismissal, desertion, and so on and so forth. These people need to be replaced. And if they're not replaced, maybe the next 6 months or 1 year, there'll be no constable in the police force.
Sir Michael Kiro also stated that the commission has devised other means to sanction and punish officers who are found guilty of misconduct. The Police Service Commission is statutorily empowered to hire, fire, or discipline police officers in the country. From Abuja, I'm Festus Ejirogo Enefifen for Ben Television.
Hi, Mike.
Babe, it's been over
12 hours. Are you done thinking about it?
Is the answer yes?
Convince me.
I know how much
confidence style means to you. Let me take you somewhere.
What's that?
A superior leading international hospitality chain in the heart of Africa.
And?
They offer very distinct services. Their meeting halls and all their hotels offer conference solutions that can help plan a perfect function for any occasion. They feature outdoor catering and provide services for any size event.
Keep going. You got me thinking now.
The beauty, the decor, and the views. It's the hotel experience you always dreamed of. They have up-to-date entertainment and a variety served at the fast food restaurant and snack bar. Oh, and don't even get me started on the garden bar or the nightclub. You would have everything you need within your reach without having to go out.
Wow. So what if I want to...
cook? They got you, babe. The rooms are thoughtfully furnished with facilities that aid proper cooking, just like you would at home.
Where is this place?
And it's sweets.
Wow.
So will you marry me?
Yes. How can I refuse?
Not at Sweets, a colorful affair.
Youths, under the auspices of the Northern Youth Business Roundtable, is advocating for youth civic engagement in governance towards contributing their quota to the economic diversification for self-reliance as Nigeria joins the rest of the youths across the world to commemorate this year's International Youth Day. The convener, Lugardo Konobo in Abuja, said the need to develop the node is of utmost importance considering the present social and economic challenges being experienced in the region, with huge population that can be converted to gainful use.
Civic engagement has to be with the involvement of youth in governance. Nigeria cannot be an exception. Nigeria signed the United Nations Treaty, and by that extension, we are meant to promote such activities that relate to that day. Our dream and desire is to see that the Northern Youth Business Roundtable emerge as a strong force to utilize all the resources that are endowed.
The group called on the Northern Governors to approve the Northern Youth Economic Council, saying the council, if approved, will serve as the medium to mentor young people in the region.
In an effort to make private universities in Nigeria to compete with other universities in the world, operators of private universities have appealed to federal government to create an education development bank to help build private institutions in the country. They made the appeal in Abuja at the presentation of operational licenses to 9 universities by the National Universities Commission, NUC.
The housing sector has a mortgage bank, federal mortgage. So that sector is also Import export is another sector that's very important to government, and that sector also has a development plan. There is also a development plan for agriculture. There's a development plan for industry and other sectors. What we have before as a education plan targeted to the low.
Consequently,
I want to suggest that we move to a strong university. In fact, the Nigerian university system is to press the government for the establishment, press for the establishment of an education development.
The Executive Secretary of NUSA, Professor Julius Okojie, on his part, said federal government will do everything possible to make private universities stand.
People who say they want to start institutions, after telling you that that name will be there forever, you are ready to send any money to be made forever. They have decided that's what they want to put in society. But government, I'm sure, there are some indirect costs that government takes care of. We'll take this to them. At least on the side of students, whether they can access loans so they can go to private institutions. But make sure that the students you also take are good students. Please, if you don't, you're going to have a problem in your campus. If it's only those who can pay, then you have a problem. But I know because of the stability of private universities, a lot of students go there.
NUC boss, who named the private universities that scaled through, said about 11 private universities was given 2 years extension as they were unable to meet the basic criteria.
Caleb University, Salem University, Veritas University, Afebarola University, Nigeria Turkish Nile University, Godfrey University, Fountain University, Adeleke University, Western Delta University. I think we would like to receive your provisional license back, isn't it?
Yeah.
So that we can issue you government.
Some of the universities that got 2 years extension were Lamar University, Wesley University of Science and Technology, Rema University, Paul University, Bayes University, among others. From Abuja, LM Chukwuemeka reports.